Namaskar, hello and welcome once again to NCERT's live phone in program. My name is Tanvi Khurana and in this maths class for all the 10th class students, hum padhne ja rahe hain polynomials. Aur ye iska second part hai. Aap please hamare YouTube channel NCERT official par iska first part uploaded hai. Use zarur dekhiyega kyunki first part aur second part connected hai. एंड अगर आपके पास कोई भी सवाल है तो आप बेझिझक हमें भेज सकते हैं. हमारा ईमेल आईडी है dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. अगर आप जानना चाहते हैं हमारे शेड्यूल के बारे में, हमारे टाइम टेबल के बारे में, तो प्लीज हमारी वेबसाइट पे विजिट कीजिए, स्वयं प्रभा या सीआईईटी की वेबसाइट, वहां पर ये सारी जानकारी आपको मिल जाएगी. हमारे साथ एक एक्सपर्ट मौजूद हैं और आइए उनसे भी मिलते हैं. हमारे साथ है मिस सविता ग्राक. स्वागत है मैम आपका.
जी तन्वी, धन्यवाद एंड नमस्कार टू ऑल ऑफ आवर ऑडियंस.
नमस्कार टू यू टू मैम. मैम है गीता निकेतन आवासीय विद्यालय में एक टीचर कुरुक्षेत्र से. और आइए मैम से पूछते हैं कि पार्ट वन में मैम ने आप सभी को क्या पढ़ाया था. और साथ ही साथ हमारे पास एक सवाल भी है जो फर्स्ट पार्ट में आया था, एक दर्शक था और उस वक्त क्योंकि टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट था हम ले नहीं पाए थे, तो आज उस सवाल को हम लेने की कोशिश करते हैं. मैम क्या हम उसी क्वेश्चन से शुरू करें?
जी तन्वी बिल्कुल, हम उसी क्वेश्चन से शुरू करते हैं. एंड इट इज अ क्वेश्चन गिवन बाय वैष्णवी गुप्ता. एंड व्हाट द क्वेश्चन इज, शी हैज अ कंफ्यूजन अबाउट रियल नंबर्स. But the confusion is that she has asked that she was unable to understand if there is a rational number and in that rational number we know that this is terminating. So first we are discussing that which type of numbers are known as terminating rational numbers and which numbers have non-terminating repeating expansion. We know that all the numbers which can be written in the form of p by q, where q is not equals to zero, these type of numbers are known as rational numbers if both p and q are integers. Now, if I am writing a number 7/15, so this is a number in which the numerator and denominator 7 and 15 has their highest common factor as 1, and 15 can be factorize as 3 into 5. So we have discussed about it, if the factors of q are in the form of 2 raised to the power n into 5 raised to the power m, in that case the number will be terminating, otherwise the number will be non-terminating repeating. So if the number is terminating, then we can find its decimal expansion without going for the whole division, completely divide किए बिना भी हम उसका आंसर दे सकते हैं. So Vaishnavi has asked us the question कि किस तरह से बिना डिवाइड किए हम आंसर दे सकते हैं, डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं. सो नाउ आई एम राइटिंग अ नंबर, लेट इट बी 3/20 एंड वी आर डूइंग इट, वी आर राइटिंग इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन विदाउट डिवाइडिंग इट कंप्लीटली. फॉर दैट वी नीड टू फैक्टराइज 20 and the factors of 20 are 2 into 2 into 5 which can be written as 2 square into 5. Now the highest power of 2 is 2 here and the highest power of 5 is 1. So what we have to do, we have to divide both numerator as well as denominator by 5. We need to equate the powers of both of these factors 2 and 5, but the power of 2 is 2, power of 5 is 1, so we need to multiply and divide by 5 raised to the power 1. And because of this we have here 15 divided by 2 square into 5 square, which is of course 10 square, and 10 square can also be written as 100. And if 10 square is 100, then your answer is, it is 0.15 simply. So in this way, हमने complete division procedure नहीं किया, but we have told कि किस तरह से decimal expansion में हम एक terminating number को लिख सकते हैं. So this was the problem taken by the child.
Okay. So I hope Vaishnavi इस वक्त आप हमारा ये session देख रही हैं और आपको अपने सवाल का जवाब मिल गया है and you're satisfied with the answer. So let's go ahead further and ma'am, what exactly are we going to learn in this particular session?
Right, Tanvi. So now we are going to discuss the first that what we have covered in our session one of polynomials. The topic polynomials in this, we have studied about linear polynomial, or we can say we have studied about various types of polynomials: linear, quadratic, cubic, biquadratic, constant polynomial. After that, we have also studied about how can we factorize especially a quadratic polynomial or a cubic polynomial. We have also studied about the zeros of a polynomial. And then we have gone through some of the graphical representations of the polynomials, or we have discussed the geometrical meaning of the zeros of a polynomial. Today, we are going to discuss about the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of a polynomial. So we know that how many zeros can a polynomial have? If our polynomial is quadratic, then there are two zeros exactly. If our polynomial is a cubic polynomial, then there are three zeros. Means whatsoever is the degree of our polynomial, that degree defines the maximum number of zeros of that particular polynomial. Let's discuss about this relationship one by one. First of all, we are discussing for a linear polynomial. If the polynomial is linear, that means the degree of the variable is one. In that case, we have, let us suppose that the function or the polynomial is ax plus b, where a is not equals to zero. The coefficient of x is not equals to zero. So what can be zero? All the values of x for which our polynomial becomes zero will be known as the zeros of the polynomial. That is why we are equating the given polynomial to zero, and from here we are able to get only one value of x, and what that value is, that is minus b upon a. It means linear polynomial has just only one zero, and that zero is represented here by x. Or agar hum baat karte hain zeros aur coefficients ki relationship ki, so this zero is equal to minus of constant term and it has been divided by the coefficient of x. Let us now discuss about the relationship between the zeros and coefficients of a quadratic polynomial. What is a quadratic polynomial? It is a polynomial whose highest degree is 2. So if the degree is 2, then what is the sum of zeros? Let me say that its zeros are presented by alpha and beta. These might be the new terms for our audience. So whenever you have to take the zeros, we are presenting these zeros by alpha and beta. And if the polynomial is cubic, then it can have at most three zeros. And then we will suppose that these zeros are alpha, beta and gamma. So what will be the sum of these zeros? Sum means alpha plus beta. The sum of zeros will be minus b upon a, where b is the coefficient of x and a is the coefficient of x square. Keep it in mind that the denominator will always be the coefficient of x square, whether we are calculating any of the relationship. Similarly, if we want to know the product of zeros, the product of zeros is c divided by a. That means the constant term from our polynomial, and it will again be divided by the coefficient of x square, which is the highest degree for a quadratic polynomial. Now let us also discuss the relationship between the zeros and coefficients of a cubic polynomial. Now the polynomial is cubic. Cubic means its highest degree is 3. Here we can say that the coefficient of x cube is a, the coefficient of x square is b, the coefficient of x is c, and the constant term is d. Thus, if alpha, beta and gamma are supposed as the zeros of our polynomial, then what can we say about their sum? Their sum, that means alpha plus beta plus gamma, the sum of the zeros will be minus b upon a. minus of coefficient of x square divided by coefficient of x cube. And what is the sum of product of zeros taken two at a time? So you might be thinking that this is little confusing, but it's not. Taken two at a time means we will take two zeros only at a time, whether alpha and beta, whether beta and gamma, or gamma and alpha. And after that, we have taken the sum of these products. Means we are discussing about alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha. And what this is again C upon A, or we can say it is equals to minus of coefficient of x whole divided by coefficient of x cube. Keep it in mind that denominator will always be the coefficient of the highest degree of our polynomial. It is a cubic polynomial, therefore the highest degree is 3, therefore the denominator will be the coefficient of x cube. Now what will be the product of all the three zeros? Means alpha into beta into gamma. It is minus d upon a, that means minus of constant term divided by the coefficient of x cube. Now let us discuss the same relationships with the help of some of the examples. Make this more clear to our audience. It is find the zeros of quadratic polynomial, and the quadratic polynomial is x square minus 2x minus 8. I need to find the zeros, and after finding the zeros, we have to verify the relationship. So first, let us factorize it. For factorizing, we have to split the middle term. We know that 4 times 2 is 8, it's minus 8, the product should be minus 8 and the sum must be minus 2. On factorizing, we are able to know that the factors for this quadratic polynomial are x minus 4 and x plus 2. Now with the help of these factors, let us calculate the zeros. If we are putting x minus 4 equals to 0, then we are getting x equals to 4. And from the second factor, we are able to get that x is equal to minus 2. That means the value of alpha can be considered as 4 and the value of beta can be considered as minus 2. After this, we have been asked to find the to verify the relationship. Means हमें verify करना है that alpha plus beta is always minus b upon a. And what in this question? The question is x square minus 2x minus a. In this question, we can say that a is equal to 1. As we know that in general, the quadratic polynomial can be written in this way. So what is the value of a? It is the coefficient of x square. We have b is equal to minus 2. We have c is equal to minus 8. And the zeros which we just have calculated, these are alpha and beta. And what these are? These are 4 and minus 2. Let us verify the first relationship. The first relationship is alpha plus beta equals to minus b upon a. Let us put all the values which are there with us. That means we are putting alpha is equal to 4 and beta equals to minus 2. Then the value of b, it is negative 2. The value of a, it is positive 1. And on calculating it, we are able to get left hand side and right hand side both are equal. If both of the sides are equal, it clarifies that this is a true relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of the given polynomial. Now the second relationship is alpha into beta equals to c upon a. Let us again put all of the values here. The value of alpha, then the value of beta, then c, and at last a. Again we are getting minus 8 equals to minus 8. That means the relationship is again true. So this is the way to verify the relationship. Now again, I have taken a quadratic polynomial. Again, the question is same. We have to find the zeros and after that, we have to verify the relationship. So the relationship part, our audience will do themselves. And we are helping them here to find the zeros of the given quadratic polynomial. this is the quadratic polynomial, and in this quadratic polynomial we need the sum to be 5√2, and the product is demanded to be 4 × −3. That means we have to split the middle term such that the sum of those two terms will be 5√2 and the product is −12. For this, the easiest way is, let us factorize this 12. And the factors of 12 are 2 × 2 × 3. Let us see that what should we, how can we rearrange these factors so that as sum we will be able to get 5√2. So it is clear that 3 × 2 = 6. And this 2 has been divided into two factors again, √2 and √2. So what are the factors with us? How can we rewrite this 5√2? It can be written as 6√2 × x minus √2 × x, or we can say 1√2 × x. How do we know about it? Actually, 6√2 − 1√2, or only √2, is 5√2, and we need positive 5√2, and the product is, if we will multiply 6√2 and √2, of course the product will be 12. So now it becomes easier for us to factorize it. 4 can also be written as 2 × √2 × √2, x² + 6√2 × x, minus, here we can see only negative sign can be common from both of these terms. And what will be the next step then? We can take 2 common from first and second term. We can see that √2 can also be taken common, and x can also be taken common. So we have taken 2√2x common, and thus we have √2x + 3 there remaining in the bracket. Yes. Now, the combination of first two terms and the combination of next two terms. Again, this √2 + x can be taken common. √2x + 3. And these are the factors of the given polynomial. And with the help of these, we will be able to find the values of alpha and beta. What will be the value of alpha then? Alpha is, of course, from here we can find the value of alpha. If we put this value equals to 0, thus alpha is there −p/√2. And what is the value of beta? Beta is 1/√2. On equating the factors to 0, you will be able to get this. Since there is √2 at the denominator, so it's a must for us to rationalize the denominator. And on rationalizing, we are getting −3√2/2, and the value of beta is √2/4. After that, we have to verify the relationship as we have done it earlier. Now, the next question. This time we are taking a cubic polynomial. In our class 10th, we will specifically study about quadratic, cubic and biquadratic polynomials. So now we are discussing about the zeros of a cubic polynomial. Since the highest degree is 3 here, so it is a cubic polynomial. And how many zeros at the most it can have? Since it is cubic, therefore it can have at most 3 zeros. Out of those 3 zeros, 2 zeros have been given to us. One is alpha. One has been considered as beta. And the third zero, let us suppose it to be gamma, and we do not know the value of gamma. How can we find this third zero? There are two ways. One way is we find the factors with the help of the given two zeros. And the second way is, let us use the relationship between these three zeros. What is that relationship? Alpha plus beta plus gamma equals to −b/a. And in this question, we have the value of a as 1, which is the coefficient of x³. What is the value of b? It is −4. What is the value of c? It is the coefficient of x. And d, it is the constant term itself. So we have put all the values which are required to be calculate the value of gamma. Let us put in place of alpha root 3, beta is minus root 3, then gamma will remain same. Value of b itself is negative 4. Do not get confused about this negative sign. This negative sign is already there in the relationship, and this negative sign is there in the value of b, and this whole has been divided by a. So what do we have? We have gamma equals to 4. That is what required, the third zero, and the third zero is gamma, which is 4. So is there any confusion or any problem from our viewers till Tanvi?
No, ma'am. Nothing so far. Everything is clear.
Okay, thank you.
And we have got last 4 minutes left. So, a question or solve kar sakte hum?
Yeah, right. So, the next question is, it is if the sum of the zeros of the quadratic polynomial, I have taken the quadratic polynomial, and this time he has given us the relationship between the sum of the zeros and their product. The question is saying that the sum of zeros, let us suppose that alpha and beta are the zeros of the given polynomial, and the sum of zeros is equal to their product, means we have been given that alpha plus beta is equal to alpha into beta. Now we know that what is alpha plus beta? It is minus b upon a. And what is alpha into beta? It is c upon a. Let us put all the values which we have with us, and it will help us to calculate the value of k. We have a equals to k, b equals to 2, and c is 3. So in place of b, 2, in place of a, k, then in place of c, 3k. The constant term is 3k, and this has been divided by k itself. So from here, we have minus 2k on cross multiplication is equal to 3k square. Thus, 3k square plus 2k is 0. And on solving it, we are able to get k is either 0 or minus 2 by 3. Agar hum factors banate hain, k ko common lete hain, aur common lene par humare paas do factors jo ban rahe hain. From one of the factor, we are getting k equals to 0. And from the other factor, we are getting k is minus 2 by 3. Now, the point is this, we will not take the value of k to be 0, but the value of k will be taken as minus 2 by 3 only. Why so? Because this is a quadratic polynomial. And if k becomes 0, then the coefficient of x square becomes 0. And if the coefficient of x square becomes 0, that means the polynomial cannot be quadratic. Thus, the highest degree becomes 1 and it becomes linear. So, we must be aware that which value has to be taken in our final answer and which value can be left.
Okay. All right. So, shall we end our session here, ma'am?
Yes, we can end, and we will proceed with the same topic in the next session again.
Absolutely. And I'll be looking forward to the third part of the same topic, polynomials. And so will our viewers. Thank you, ma'am, for this class and for your time.
Thank you, Tanvi. Thanks to our viewers.
Thank you to all the viewers. And I hope, Vaishnavi, aapki tarah aur bhi bachon ne jo bhi sawal aapke dimag mein huwe ho, ma'am ne unhi solve karne ki koshish ki hai. थैंक यू. इसी तरह आप और सवाल हमें भेज सकते हैं हमेशा. हमारा ईमेल आईडी है dth.class10@cit.nic.in. PME विद देयर चैनल्स देखते रहिए और अपना बहुत बहुत ख्याल रखिएगा, क्योंकि बाहर COVID-19 अभी भी जारी है. और मास्क जरूर पहनिएगा अगर आप बाहर जाएं, और अगर जरूरी ना हो तो बाहर बिल्कुल मत जाइएगा. थैंक यू. नमस्ते.